Ever pondered why Shakespeare's characters often address each other as thou, while in modern English we stick to you, regardless of whether we're speaking to one person or many? It's a fascinating delve into the evolution of language, and today we'll be exploring the journey of thou and you through different periods of English language history. Once upon a time in the Old English period, around the 5th to 12th centuries, the language had a singular and plural form for the second person pronoun, much like many other languages. Thou was the singular and you was the plural. So if you were speaking to one person, you'd say thou, and if you were addressing a group, you'd use you. It was a clear, functional system. But as we moved into the Middle English period, from the late 12th to late 15th centuries, things started to get a little more complex. You began to be used not just as a plural form, but also as a polite singular form. If you wanted to show respect to someone, you was the way to go. Thou, on the other hand, started to be seen as less formal, even disrespectful in some contexts. Fast forward to the early modern English period from the late 15th to late 17th centuries, and this is where our friend thou really started to fall out of favor. You was now the dominant form, used in both singular and plural contexts. It was during this time that we see the prolific use of thou in Shakespeare's works, but this was more of a stylistic choice, a nod to the conventions of the past, rather than a reflection of common usage. By the time we reached the late modern English period from the 18th century onwards, thou had all but disappeared from everyday speech. It was seen as archaic, confined to the realms of literature and religious texts. Today, you reigns supreme, used universally in both singular and plural contexts. So to summarize, the journey of thou and you in English language history is a tale of evolution and change. Thou started as the singular form with you as the plural, but as social norms and conventions shifted, you took over, becoming the polite singular form, then the dominant form in both singular and plural contexts. Thou gradually fell into disuse and is now considered archaic, a relic of a bygone era. The absence of a verbal distinction between thou and you today raises intriguing questions about the nature of language and how it evolves. It shows us that language is not a static entity, but a dynamic, ever-changing phenomenon shaped by social, cultural, and historical forces. And it prompts us to ponder, what changes might the English language undergo in the future? Only time will tell. For now, we continue to navigate the linguistic landscape with you as our trusty companion, a testament to the fascinating journey of language evolution.